This is one of the greatest emergencies our nation has faced in generations.
Roughly one in four Americans are now being told, stay at home.
Tighten the valve more. If the number doesn't slow down, close the valve. We're closing the valve.
Hello everyone. The current situation with COVID-19 is unprecedented. We must respond, not just as a nation fighting an enemy, but as a species fighting for survival. There are two critical steps in fighting this war. One is to create awareness about the exposure risk and provide necessary tools for people to self-quarantine when getting exposed. Number two, build more accurate data to predict the location where the infection rate could increase more and plan the distribution of short-supplied medical and other critical resources on priority. Our current challenge to address both the problem is a lack of clear and accurate actionable insight for the government officials and law enforcement agencies to make informed decisions. Our proposed solution addresses these problems by connecting the user's location info and the COVID test result data to build necessary insight and tools to help tackle the situation.
So the first ones are the two blue colored boxes that you see on the left, which basically is the data that is flowing into our system. The first one is the subsystem that is fetching the location tracking data and the contact tracking data from providers such as Google, Apple, Facebook, and any other provider that is providing location and contact tracking data over time. And the second blue box is the one where we are fetching the test results data from providers such as CDC or Johns Hopkins or Quest Diagnostics, LabCorp, and so on. And the second subsystem that you see here is the one in the red, which is at the middle of the architecture diagram. So that is our algorithm. It basically takes into account several parameters, like when was the testing done, when was the sample taken, what is the incubation time, and several other parameters. And what it does is it computes a list of all the people who are at risk of being exposed to a person who tested positive, or to people who could have been contagious. So the one that you see in the orange box is our notification service, which takes this at-risk people, and then it tries to notify them that they're at risk so that they can take the recommended guidelines and quarantine themselves and take care of themselves as well as their near and dear ones. And the second subsystem to the right of that is the one in green, which basically is an API that you can use to find out if a given location at a given point in time is safe to enter or not, based on whether the at-risk people are already present there or not, right? So you can stay away from such places. Or the fourth subsystem that you see here is the one in the pink color at the top of the architecture diagram to the right. And that subsystem is the one that is taking the at-risk people, and it is basically taking the at-risk people and the at-risk locations, and then it is computing a bunch of reports based on a model that we provide, which basically determines the number of sick people to expect over the next few days or few weeks in a given geography, and also we generate heat maps and so on.
Number one use case is going to be about providing meaningful and actionable insights to improve the operational readiness in a given geography. This is to aid the government and law enforcement officials as well as healthcare providers, so they can plan hospital beds or medical equipment that are needed in their geography, and also they prevent the further spread by enforcing certain laws in that geography.